Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. Thanks for tuning in again. Today I want to talk a bit about how MapleStory has changed over these past few years, and more specifically how it has changed after the 5th job advancement update, after the V update. So that's what this video will be about. We'll talk a bit about how I experienced these changes, and if you've been playing this game for like a long time and you've been playing still up until now, then you probably also are already aware of this change. This change of meta, the change of how, when things are important in the game. So before the V patch and probably before Big Bang, for a long time, everything that was important in the MapleStory was in the early levels. Grinding took a while, leveling took a while, and it took a while to reach level 30, and then it took a while to reach level 70. And once you reached around level 100, that's when you kind of got to the end game already. There was like four jobs at that point, and then there were 100 more levels, but there wasn't really that much content. There were no team dungeons, there were a few quest lines that you could do, but after that, it was just grinding, doing some bosses, but nothing really that furthered the game. And even when the level cap was raised until level 250, that didn't really change that much. So after level 100, the content of the game at least kind of stopped. And I've been noticing this is like a very big change that recently, like it happened especially after the V update, because then the whole 5th job advance was released, of course, but also the new Arcana River area, and most of the game is actually centering around that right now. So while before it took a while to get to level 30, it took a while to get to level 100, etc., right now you just race through that content, and you like level 150 is pretty easy for casual players like myself. Level 200 is a bit harder, but still not that hard. But actually, right now, level 200 is for most people is when the game actually begins, because that's when the real grinding begins. That's when you have to farm items, you have to farm your Arcana symbol, stuff like that. You have to do quests. That's when you can do the bossing. That's when your 5th job advancement unlocks. So that's a big change, and that's also one of the reasons I think why we don't see that many people party questing anymore, because you fly through so much content early on so easily, especially with all these burning events. The XP curve has been changed, so a lot of things are different compared to how they were before. So I'm not here to judge if they are like good or bad. I think that the game has to change over time to like stay fresh, stay renewed, stay up to date. Not saying that all changes are good, not saying that all changes are bad, but that's just, you know, that's just how it is. But there was a bit of a gap between level 100 and level 200, especially, no, let's say level 150 and 200. So well, level 1 and level 150 wasn't that much to do either, but at least was some stuff to do. But for like level 30 to level 100, there are a lot of theme dungeons, there are a lot of stuff to do, and for level 100 to level 150, there still was some okay stuff to do, some party quests, some stuff was going on, you know, but after level 150, not that much really. And I've been noticing like a lot of the content we've been getting released that isn't level 200 plus content is actually aimed towards like between level 150 and level 200, so to make sure that you get there faster and better, right? But it's still kind of a shame that the content isn't that... It's pretty forgettable nowadays compared to how it was before. Mostly because even though the team dungeons right now, they give like mesos, which are pretty nice. They give like, that's a pretty good reward if you're just starting. But their equipment and all the stuff that they reward is not that good. And like party quest, people don't really do them anymore, because by the time you actually found a party and you can do the party quest, you already probably already leveled up by just training on monsters, because you just leveled breeze through the content so fast. And that's kind of a shame. I like that the new team dungeons, the next NES release, they are like a bit more like party related, so they promote party play a little bit, but still I would like to see like party quests coming back, people hanging out together a bit more. It'll be nice, you know. But unfortunately, that's not the meta of the game right now. The meta is get to level 200, that's when the game actually starts, and everything else is kind of forgettable, which is kind of sad. It doesn't mean that you just can't, it doesn't mean that you shouldn't do the content that's already like level 30 to level 150, like all the team dungeons and stuff like that, but it just means that you don't have to, and you can actually level up way faster if you just do other stuff like train, while if you do the team dungeon, you might get a reward, but you'll probably get something better after like one of levels anyway, and you do it with it, you can do that easily within a day though. So actually I want to do this video as a part of a like welcome back guide to MapleStory, but I realized I did something like that already a month ago. Damn it, curse you, making everyday videos, I already did this topic. So I just wanted to make a quick video about how MapleStory has changed, how the meta has changed, how it has evolved to how it is right now. So if you're getting back to MapleStory, don't be alarmed by the leveling speed. Level 200 to level 250 still is a hell of a grind. It's even more grindier than it was to get to level 200 before, and there's a lot more stuff that you have to do daily as well. So what do you guys think of this change, of the changed MapleStory? Let me know in the comments. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.